Hollywood. The heart of the entertainment world. The Hollywood Palace. With your host, Van Dunsen. Tonight, the Bergeron Trio. Sergio Franchi, Paul Gilbert, Betty Grable, the Chambers Brothers, Jackie Mason, Mimi Zerbini, the Zeros, Mitchell Ayers and the Hollywood Palace Orchestra, all brought to you by Tegrin, the brand new discovery for psoriasis sufferers, works great ways to relieve the itching and scaling of psoriasis, and by Contact, the capsule with the tiny time pills for all day or all night relief from head cold congestion. Contact. We'll return to the Hollywood Palace after a word from one of our sponsors.
This is Linda. She has her mother's eyes, her father's smile, and her brother's cold. Yes, sneezes and sniffles can often spread cold germs around the family. But Contact helps keep those sneezes and sniffles under control. Each Contact capsule contains over 600 tiny time pills. Hour after hour, some Contact time pills dry runny nose. Others help clear nasal congestion, thus relieving its pressure. And Contact time pills stop sneezes too. All work together to give you fast, continuous relief for up to 12 full hours. And when Linda doesn't sneeze, she doesn't spread germs as easily. Contact capsules. Now, look what's new in Nasal Mist. New Contact Nasal Mist. Sprays away nasal congestion in seconds. New Contact Nasal Mist.
And now, from the Hollywood Palace, here is your host, the famous screen star, Van Johnson!
Starting playing, then I get a feeling that needs obeying. I feel like singing, cause that's how I am. I confess, I'm a ham. When I'm at the theater and they begin it, I get irritated if I'm not in it. Show me a spotlight and purple's to scram. I confess, I'm a ham. Don't care if it's Broadway, Boston, Alabama, or Austin, that I'm making my way to. I'll play those one-night stanzas from Keokuk to Kansas, long as there's an audience to play to. Book me on a benefit in Oswego. Something keeps on happening to my ego. I'll play a smoker in old Amsterdam. I confess, I'm a ham. Don't care if it's Vegas, Philly, Keokuk, or Chile, that I'm making my way to. I'll take a bus or a bike it. I'd even hike it, long as there's an audience to play to. Book me up in Canada when it's freezing, or in Miami Beach when it's out of season. I'd be content playing Boston in Lent, or a one-night stand in Siam. I'll develop lots of specialties to make the people flip. I'll buy myself a saxophone, I can cultivate my lip. I can learn to tame a tiger, maybe juggle, even strip. I'm a great A, sugar cured.
Good evening, and welcome to the Hollywood Palace. It's nice being back in Hollywood. I was in Europe for a while. I came back as soon as I saw an American newsreel with a lot of signs saying, "We love Johnson." I thought they meant me. A lot of you probably have been seeing my movies on the Late Late Show. I don't know how I come over on live television, but if you're up at 2 in the morning, I'm the youngest Van Johnson you ever saw. But there's one thing in Hollywood that hasn't changed. It's still the glamour capital of the world. And it's my pleasure to be appearing tonight with one of the greatest glamour girls of them all, Betty Grable. Along with Miss Grable in the Hollywood Palace tonight, you'll be seeing Sergio Franchi, Jackie Mason, Paul Gilbert, and some exciting novelties. But right now, the dancing sensations of Paris, the Bel Caron Trio. Brightest and most versatile young men, with his own original comedy creation that's been fracturing audiences all over the world, Paul Gilbert.
May I say it's delightful to be with you this evening, and I must make an apology. I didn't think I was going to be able to work. I've been very sick. Not physically, I've been what you call mentally upset, and I've been going to one of those psychiatrists, but I'm all right now. All right now! If I keep that up, I'm going to get a doctor. I've been figuring out, why should I spend money for a doctor? You know, I'll stay home and watch the doctors on television. Do you realize how many doctor's shows they have on television now? They have shows like Ben Casey, Dr. Kildare, The Nurses, The Doctors and the Nurses, General Hospital. Well, tonight, with your permission, I'd like to show you the latest of the medical shows on television. And the star of the show is a brilliant physician and surgeon who just completed a sensational, two sensational appendectomies, three abominables, and here is the star of the new television show, Hootenanny Doctor.
Where's the camera?
Good evening. Well, we take another appendix out and do-da. We convalesce and the bill goes down all the do-da day. John Henry was a steel driver man, drove with a steel gun string. Oh, yeah. But tonight, for the first time, we... whenever we operate on TV, we always assemble a competent staff. We have an assistant surgeon, two or three nurses, and an anesthetist. An anesthesiologist. We got a good gas man. Then we scrub. And we are certainly utilizing these new miracle drugs that are emanating daily from our laboratory. Oh, there's a gang of new drugs coming out. We have the sulfur family, sulfur thiazole, sulfur paradigm, sulfur denial. I used to be a baby doctor, but I grew up. I love being a doctor. That's the only business in the world where you can tell a woman to remove her clothes and send the bill to her husband, right? Keep sending those cards in, folks. Del Rio, Texas. A lot of people have asked me to describe the instruments we use when we operate. That is the nomenclature of this particular cliche here, Norman. What the heck is that one, huh? That's a scapula. S-K-K-A-A-U-P-U-L-A. With the cut-cut-heat. And the cut-cut-bear. Feet up, pat him on the booty. Tonight, for the first time on TV, we proudly present... the birth of a baby, right here in our studio. And we're just... would you throw it back, please? We're delighted to have this cultural feature as part of our program, Wide World of Sport. Medicine, excuse me. Just lie still, madam. I'll be right with you. On TV tonight, four short commercials, and off we go. Hold on, my shoulder. And I'd like to... don't be nervous, dear. I'm the finest obstetrician available, and madam... I beg your pardon, sir. Who changed the patient? I was supposed to be obstetrics. Did you know that... that today the average person is not cognizant of the fact there are no shortcuts into a career of medicine. It is so specialized, so competitive, and not only do you have to have an accredited medical college background, but an all-time serve the community, sharing the knowledge gained through years of practical experience, developing through research a higher level and a better relationship between the patient and the doctor, knowing today that we have developed this. That can't be right. But today, it's not enough to be a fine physician. You have to be a competent diagnostician. You have to have the dignity and the character, the background, and the patience. You miserable son of a gun. We're on TV. Oh, I'm sorry. But so many outstanding new developments. Tonight you're going to see the Diesel Dorf case. Mrs. Diesel ran over her husband with a large Dorf. Very spectacular accident occurred. The bumper pierced the upper lumbarnic area of the lumbar tract in the middle ventricular and split his spleen. Split it, it darn near harpooned him. He is in pain. There he was, lying in this huge pool of bleed. And when we backed over him in that ambulance, I... You're suffering. I know, but you gotta fill out all the forms first. Otherwise, But ladies and gentlemen, let's face it, to be a great physician or a great surgeon, you have to study like mad. You have 3 years of pre-med, 4 years of medical college, 2 years on TV with your own series. It takes you 7 years just to learn how to get these gloves on. Oh, well, he probably wouldn't have lived anyway.
That fall he takes is one of the hardest I've ever seen anybody do. We'll be back in a minute with Sergio Franchi.
What's the matter with her skin?
Those scaly patches on skin or scalp that you can't hide. That's the heartbreak of psoriasis. Heartbreaking, too, when medications you've tried fail to bring relief. But now there's a new medicated formula that's guaranteed. It's called Tegrin. New Tegrin guarantees three-way relief from the itching and scaling of psoriasis or your money back. No matter where psoriasis strikes, Tegrin speeds soothing relief from itching, works fast to remove scales, and continued use on affected areas helps keep scales from coming back. Tegrin leaves skin cleaner, clearer, smoother.
Tegrin isn't greasy, and there's no medical smell.
Get new Tegrin, guaranteed three-way relief. Now, another new product from Tegrin, new Tegrin medicated shampoo, especially formulated to wash away loose psoriasis scales, leaves hair and scalp cleaner and healthier looking. New Tegrin medicated shampoo.
Now, here's a big new star who is handsome, talented, and has a great career ahead of him. No wonder he's got something to sing about. The fabulous Sergio Franchi.
In the still of the night, as I gaze from my window at the moon in its flight, my thoughts go straight to you. In the still of the night, while the world is in più prezioso ci sei tu. Al di là del sogno più ambizioso ci sei tu. Al di là delle cose più belle, al di là delle stelle, al di là ci sei tu per me, soltanto per me. Al di là means you are far above me, very far. Al di là, as distant as the lovely evening star. In the kiss that I gave was the love that I gave for the lifetime. When I knew part of you was completely mine. Al di là del male più profondo ci sei tu. Al di là dei limiti del mondo ci sei tu. Al di là della volata infinita, al di là della vita ci sei tu. Al di là ci sei tu.
Great. He'll be back in a little while with Betty Grable.
Time you discovered Salem filter cigarettes? Salem freshens your taste while it brings you full tobacco flavor. Rich tobacco taste, menthol soft flavor. That's Salem.
Salem flavor freshens your taste. Smoke Salem cigarettes.
Salem flavor freshens your taste.
Now, all the way from the distant land of Iran, two balancing wizards who defy every known law of equilibrium. The Jambaz Brothers. Thank you. now two knives, just two knives between them. One of the most dangerous feats ever attempted. As guest surgeons on Ben Casey. You know, when I was making all those musicals at MGM, I took a lot of dancing lessons, and after 2 years, I danced like Catherine Murray and looked like Arthur. But here are six other dancing pupils who are waiting for their prize teacher. And here's the glamorous teacher, Miss Betty Grable.
We're doing the tango. You boys, in spite of all the dancing lessons you've bought, out on the dance floor have but one school of thought, and that is anything but what Arthur Murray taught. Please, Mr. Smith, it's a lady that you are dancing with. There's a time and a place for romancing, but not while we're dancing the tango.
Thank you.
There's a time and a place for romancing, but not while we're dancing. The tango!
Ole, oh, Betty, that was wonderful. You know, I haven't seen you since you were a 20th Century Fox making a picture with Dan Daly. And Harry James used to call for you every night to take you to dinner.
Yes, it was quite exciting. I was with Dan Daly and Harry Knightley.
Well, blondes always did have more fun. And you'll have more fun, too, right after the station break. Betty will be back along with Sergio Franchi, Jackie Mason, the Zeros, and some hijinks in the flying trapeze by Mimi Zerbini from Paris. Welcome to the second portion of the Hollywood Palace. I'm Van Johnson, your pin-up boy from World War II. The only guy who ever flew 200 missions over the Brown Derby. We have lots more show for you. Jackie Mason will be out in a few minutes. But right now, Europe's most daring aerial artist, Mimi Zerbini.
the man who can't stand the feel of grease on his hair, now a new kind of hairdressing, new Groom and Clean. Not a greasy cream, not an oily liquid, not alcohol. Groom and Clean is the new crystal clear cleansing formula that can actually clean hair with every combing. Greasy creams may build up excess grease and oil in your hair, but Groom and Clean cleans it away. Embarrassing dandruff? Groom and Clean cleans it away. Groom and Clean is grease-free. And look, put a leading cream here. Groom and Clean here. Try rinsing them off with plain water. The leading cream won't rinse clean. It still feels greasy. But Groom and Clean rinses clean. See? No greasy feel here. Groom and Clean leaves hair neatly in place, looking clean, feeling clean. For the man who can't stand the feel of grease on his hair, new Groom and Clean cleans your hair with every combing.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, a young man who's become one of the most talked about comedians in the world without hardly having lifted a finger, Jackie Mason.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's certainly a pleasure to be me. Happened to be a very big hit. And I am very proud to be introduced by Van Johnson, who's such a symbol of wholesomeness and morality and dignity in this country. But that's very important. It certainly is. Goldwater was right. I don't know if you heard about it. He was talking about morality very often. And President Goldwater said only last week. What are you laughing at? He came close. He only lost by a lousy 87 million votes. Actually, he would have won. He would have won. But let's be honest about it. Are you busy, mister? You want to listen to this? He's looking at me like he's waiting for a comedian to show up. I hope you don't mind if I laugh. I know what's coming next. I was thinking about this with President Goldwater. A lot of people think that he lost because maybe he was the wrong man. He was the right man, but you can't beat Johnson. It's impossible. He's too promising a president. He promised everything to everybody. He promised so much, I heard a rumor that Goldwater voted for him. How could you beat a man like Johnson? Do you know what I'm talking about, mister? Let me talk to you. You look to me like you'll believe anything. You see, Johnson has got this. You see, I can let you in on a secret. I happen to know everything about politics. Not that I want to mix in it. I'm going to Russia anyway. Russia is a great place. The only place in the world where they're not worried about communism. That's my best joke. Help out. I want to tell you something. You see, what happened was that Goldwater ran in the wrong time. The timing was wrong. Not the man, the timing. He ran at the beginning of November, just when Johnson was running. That's not the time to run. The best thing to do is to wait. Let Johnson run himself. Then in February, when Johnson is on the ranch. The idea is never to run against Johnson, to run against Stevenson. You can't lose. The only guy that could lose to Stevenson is maybe Nixon. I don't know. I like before the election, the way Nixon came out with a statement. He said he had no doubt. He had no doubt that Goldwater was going to win. Look who was picking a winner, a professional. You know what I would have liked to see? I would have liked to see a campaign between Stevenson and Nixon. This would have been a great campaign. Nobody would win. You're not too excited about that? I want to tell you about Goldwater. You see, I don't want to talk about policy. In a way, I'm happy Goldwater lost. Not that I think he's bad. I think he's a great man. I really do. And there's no question about it. But when a guy owns a department store, I get very nervous. You want a department store owner to be the president? Let's assume the country is doing great, but the store is having a very bad season. You think they'll be thinking about the country at a time like this? Everybody will holler and move the troops. I'll say, forget it. Move the shirts. The head of Russia will come to visit and will say, listen, I came to talk to you about South Vietnam. We'll say, wait a second. I got something for you in a light blue, you know? It gets me very nervous just to think about it. It don't bother you, I know. Right in the front, I needed the snips. In the back, I'm a sensation, but I don't hear from them. I want to tell you something. You know, I am not the type of person that mixes in politics. I happen to be a very close friend of George Murphy, the senator. I don't know if you heard about it. Don't tell him. He don't know it either. Oh, yes, sir. As a matter of fact, I'm very personally proud of the fact that he's a senator now. As I say, I don't mix in politics, but he picked me out to travel with him throughout the country for Republican campaign fund dinners throughout America. As a matter of fact, I never thought at that time that he would be a senator. He was a song and dance man. I'm not surprised at that. I have a senator that's been giving me a song and a dance for years. I guarantee you he'll get along very well with President Johnson. They may not vote together, but they'll dance together. Is that the best you can do for my best jokes? I was thinking, if he makes a great senator, which I'm sure he'll make, he'll be able to run for president. Imagine if he's in the United Nations as a president, George Murphy, and he's in a debate with a Polish delegate, and the Polish delegate will holler, "Yenya chazdajesz demonia! Yenya chalaya!" What do you think George Murphy will say? I want to tell you something. I'm proud of George Murphy, because we need the best men that we could get in our government, and that's our problem. The problem is that we have no qualifications to become a congressman in this country. Anybody. I could run for Congress if I wanted to. You stop to think what this country is coming to. Anybody could run for Congress. There's no qualifications. If you want to be a doctor, you have to go to college. You know that? A lawyer, you must go to college. Even a football player, you must go to college. But if you want to become a congressman, you don't. Did you know that? That's why there's such great football players in this country and such lousy country. Thanks a lot. I begin to notice I'm catching on. You can't be a hit with everything because you can't please everybody. The best men are very often rejected in this country. Take a look at what happened to Bobby Baker. The first guy to show a profit for this country takes it. What hurts me is that he's not a president. I wish he would become president. We would all make a fortune and nobody would know from what. You know what a fantastic man Bobby Baker is? From $9,000 a year, he's worth now $7 million. $7 million from $9,000, and he did this quietly. He was ashamed. Nobody could know. Imagine if he could advertise. I'm telling you the truth. We pick on Bobby Baker, and there's so much communism all over the world today, we don't even fight it. And even when we try fight it, we can't win. Do you notice how we keep losing? Anybody? We keep losing. It's President Johnson said a brilliant thing about this whole situation last week. I would like to tell you what he said, but I don't understand him. I like the way he talks, but I don't understand it. No matter what you ask him, he keeps saying, "I'm very happy, I'm very glad. The land is fine, the land is perfect." By the time you get through the answer, I forgot the question. I couldn't kid the president, although it's a great thing to live in a country like this, where anybody, even a person like me, could walk up and kid the president himself. And he'll laugh at it, because this is a great democracy. This is the difference between us and communism, where you could get up and talk about anything you please. And no matter how much people disagree with you, they respect your right to say it. And that's a magnificent thing. You could say anything you want. Of course, if you lift a finger.
I've been appearing in theaters and nightclubs in Europe and all over these United States. And I've been on many bills with many exciting acts, but nothing compares with the one that's coming out now. Ladies and gentlemen, from the continent, the Zeros. crazy about this lady. Betty Grable and Sergio Franchi will be on stage in a minute, and so will I.
Where you see marching children, experts on tooth decay see their dental records. Analyzed by this impartial computer in the latest clinical research on tooth decay, findings confirm Colgate a leader in reducing new cavities. Compared with the well-known fluoride brand, Colgate's Gardol formula is unsurpassed. Tastes best, too. Helps stop bad breath. Stops mouth odor for most people instantly. And Colgate is a leader in reducing new cavities. It's just got to be the best toothpaste for your family.
Stronger than dirt. New Ajax laundry detergent is stronger than dirt.
Who says Ajax is stronger than dirt? Good Housekeeping wanted to know. So the Good Housekeeping Institute used Ajax on sheets, towels, pillowcases. Now, Good Housekeeping agrees.
New Ajax laundry detergent is stronger than dirt.
I wanna be happy, but I won't be happy till I make you happy too. Life's only worth living when you are forgiven. Why can't I give some to you? When skies are gray and you say you are blue, I'll send the sun shining through. I wanna be happy, but I won't be happy till I make you happy too. There are girls just ripe for some kissing, and I mean to kiss me a few. All those girls don't know what they're missing. There's such a lot of living to do. And there's wine just ready for tasting. And there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time is a-wasting. There's such a lot of living to do. There's music to play, places to go and people to see. Everything for you and me. Life's a ball, if only you know it. And it's all just waiting for you. You're alive, so come on and show it. There's such a lot of living, such a lot of living. There's an awful lot of living.
Bravo, bravissimo.
Thank you, thank you. Now that we're out here together, let's give them what they really want. Hoke.
Hoke? What's a hoke?
Explain it to them, Betty.
Well, for example, if you sit on a pizza to get a laugh, that's hoke.
And if I hit you with a pie right in the middle of one of your romantic songs, Sergio, what would that be?
Suicide.
Well, let's put it another way. They should erect a statue to the guy who first thought of hitting someone with a pie.
Call it hokum hoke or what you will, it sure got a laugh, they're laughing still.
And nothing sounds quite as glorious as a laugh that's real uproarious. Give them elegant prose.
No coward gone low.
You'll get notices, but you'll go broke if the heroes fluster.
Hit them with a custard.
You gotta get the people home.
Do your best to jeté from a classic ballet.
And they'll rush to the lobby and smoke.
At a tiny platform, you'll be running that hall.
You gotta get the people home.
The critics may say that it's trash.
But trash or not, it's a smash.
And
but crowds are standing in line. 'Cause Hedda thinks it's just fine. Every year at the Met, they go deeper in debt.
You would think that it's time they awoke.
They don't want Hayashi, give them Liberace. It would be a master stroke.
You gotta get the people, the ticket buying people. You gotta give the people.
What in the world are you waiting for? When you suffer from irregularity, don't wait. Get the relief you need with Philips Milk of Magnesia. Doctors recommend Milk of Magnesia. When thousands of doctors were asked if they ever recommended Milk of Magnesia, the overwhelming majority said they did. You see, Philips Milk of Magnesia is the balanced laxative for more complete relief than any single-purpose laxative can bring. See these two words? Antacid, laxative. As a laxative, Philips works thoroughly but gently for truly comfortable relief. As an antacid, Philips relieves upset stomach, heartburn, and other acid distresses which frequently accompany irregularity. No single-purpose laxative can give such complete yet gentle relief. Ask your doctor about famous Philips Milk of Magnesia. It's the balanced laxative for more complete relief. So when you know you need a laxative, don't put it off. Take Philips Milk of Magnesia, regular or mint flavored.
Next week at this time, your ABC station will present the glamorous Deb Star Ball from Hollywood. And 2 weeks from tonight, here are some of the exciting things you'll see in the Hollywood Palace. Gene Bayless, Bertha and Tina, Hayes and Bray, Rowan and Martin, the Three Getchies, Janie Wallace, Edward G. Robinson, and your host, Liberace. Liberace and Edward G. Robinson, it sounds like a great show. I'll be watching even if one of my old movies is on. Good night, everybody.
Palace has been brought to you by the laundry detergent that puts white strength in your wash. New Ajax laundry detergent with Ultramarine Plus. It's stronger than dirt. Forget 2 weeks from tonight at the Hollywood Palace. Gene Bayless, Bertha and Tina, Paige and Dre, Rowan and Martin, the Three Getchies, Janie Wallace, Edward G. Robinson, and your host, Liberace. This is Dick Tufeld speaking.
Buckle up for safety, buckle up. Buckle up for safety, always buckle up. Pull your seatbelt snug, give an extra tug. Buckle up for safety, buckle up.
Buckle up for safety, buckle up. Buckle up. buckle up. For safety, always buckle up.
The National Safety Council says, if you don't have seatbelts, get them. If you do have seatbelts, use them.